On this episode of the Global Snowbirds, we take you around the Gaul Dutch Fort and give you an idea of what to expect. People actually hid in this fort and survived. Should have got a tour guide. Too much of a nerd to come here and just guess.
I had no idea that there was a town inside of the wall.
Really doesn't feel like you're in Sri Lanka.
Sup, snowbirds! Welcome to Gale Dutch Fort.
Gaul.
We don't know how to pronounce it.
This is an old fort built in like the 1600s. It's a big, sprawling, complex little town on the little peninsula here in the edge of Gale. Gale.
See?
Yeah.
And actually, it's 1588.
Oh, ooh. Thesaurus over there.
Thesaurus. Thesaurus is like a synonym. It's
a word thing.
Anyways, so we took a quick 15-minute scooter ride over here. So far, haven't had to pay any parking fee or an entrance fee.
Anyways, we're gonna go explore this cool little quaint town. I think first stop is right behind us, the clock tower. It's cool. So unlike most, you know, historical tourist attraction, you're kind of led along a path and can't really wander off or venture on your own. But here, you got free reign, you can pretty much go wherever you want. Everywhere. It's cool. It's pretty neat. It's trippy. So one cool bit of information that guy did give us is that some of the part is actually made out of coral because they started running out of stone, which is doesn't seem the safest. But I'm gonna go check out one of them arrow things, them arrow shooting spots. Hard to imagine this place is under siege 500 years ago. What are those? Apparently, I'm not funny. So crazy to imagine a few hundred years ago, English sailors, Royal Navy sailors, fucking invading this place, trying to climb up these walls and take it from the Dutch, or the Portuguese, whoever were here first. I guess the Portuguese were here first, but it's a Dutch fort, so I assume British were the last ones to invade. Oh look, there's bananas. It's a good position for a fort, that's for sure.
Pretty what?
That it's a good position for a fort.
Yes.
You can see all the coast around you. You can see who's coming in. Half the city. Oh, hey, puppy. Hi. To try and see it all, we're gonna go around the perimeter and then maybe do a little zigzag or grid around this interior.
It's really, really hot. It's like 36 degrees or something.
Yeah, and you're totally exposed because there's no trees up at the top of the fort here.
And barely any clouds.
Yeah. Maybe in town. In the town there's some shade.
Shade!
I guess this would have been the moat divider. Once they climb up the wall, they'd have to jump over the moat. Cool. It's pretty neat. So I overheard someone say that in 2004, when the tsunami hit at Christmas, the one that destroyed most of Southeast Asia, people actually hid in this fort and survived because it's got such big walls and it's so strongly built. Yeah, key bit of information for you there, eh? Huh? Ooh, pagoda. I really want to know what this thing was meant for. Is it like a cannon rotating spot or something? Maybe a catapult? Hey look, there's Megan. I'm pretty stoked on this place. I'm a big fan of the pirate era. So it's cool to be here. My mind's just wandering of how someone would invade this place. Especially because there's a reef. So like the ship would have to stop before the reef and then have to ferry men in. This is crazy. Watch where you're going.
2 seconds ago I said, I want ice cream. Turn the corner. Ask and you shall receive. How are you?
Yeah.
Good. What do I feel like?
Stubborn. Quick tip to beat the heat. You can't cool down the exterior, cool down the interior.
Dork.
I'm dying to know how old these buildings are behind me. They look relatively new, but they have that old school era feeling. But there's clearly like other buildings that are like semi-demolished that you can tell are original buildings. Should have got a tour guide. Too much of a nerd to come here and just guess. My geekiness wants to know.
We also can't even look up anything because our data on our SIM card stopped working.
Yeah, we got ripped off. If it turns out that we only got 25 gigs instead of 40 from the airport Mobitel, we'll let you know. And see if we got scammed at the airport. It's strange. Yeah, it came right in front of the camera. I think he's going for the eggs, that's why he's freaking out.
What eggs?
I don't know.
Oh my god, you were so cool!
This should not be happening with these right there. We should have brought our bathing suits.
Yeah, we weren't really thinking.
We also didn't know that there was swimming here, so. Could have gone for a dip to beat the heat. Not today, I guess. It's gonna boil. Up. Oh, yo.
Dead end.
Okay, so we've made it around the perimeter wall. So you think that this place is just a historical fort, but actually it's a fully functioning town.
I had no idea that there was a town inside of the walls.
Yeah, it's like restaurants, hotels, bars, shops.
This place is massive.
Yeah, it's shiny. It is a cool, cool place. I wish we knew about this because it's actually stayed in the fort. Probably a little bit expensive, but that would have been
cool. There's a police station.
Police barracks, wow. Just look at this road that we're walking through. Behind me, but prices on these restaurants are pretty similar to anywhere around the city. The fancy Western food kind of thing. Lots of diamond shops, lots of jewelry stores, and almond shops, and shiny things.
Shiny.
So now we're gonna walk in and around the town. Maybe find ourselves a bar.
ATM
first, because we're. place is so cool.
It reminds me of Phuket Town.
Yeah, it really doesn't feel like you're in Sri Lanka. It's got a very Dutch feeling to it.
Oh my god. Hey, there's a lion deer shirt.
Lion deer? Ooh. So for you, for those of you who don't know, I try to get the local beer t-shirt whenever I go to each country. And I'm staring at a lion beer t-shirt. So maybe I should smoke on. Let's see how much this. $15.
Nope.
Nope. Budget's $2. $2
for... You could do $4.
Yeah, maybe $4 for a tourist t-shirt. Maybe. Maybe.
That's okay.
Yeah, $4 is okay, I guess.
$5 is okay.
$5 might be okay, I guess. Look at this tea. There's lots of tea shops here too, guys. If you're into that kind of thing, which I am, but I don't got the money for it. Or the room in a bag. So. Keep on exploring, I guess. See if we can find other cool stuff.
Cool.
What's that?
This place is so cool.
Standing in the middle of the road.
But it's like really expensive. Ritzy inside. But yeah, if we had more money, it'd be a cool place to stay, cool place to eat and drink and shop.
Frolic. Well guys, we are back at the entrance. Made our way in and around. Out around and in.
I think we were here for like 3 hours or something.
Yeah, we got here at like noon. It's now 2:30. Yeah, it's a good day.
Very sweaty.
Had fun. Yes, very sweaty.
But this place is so cool. You guys have to come check it out.
Definitely.
But maybe have a little higher budget than the surrounding beach. But surrounding beaches.
Yeah. Anyways, thanks for watching.
And if you guys are new here, please hit the subscribe button. Come show us some love.
See you in the next one. Bye. And today we are leaving for India.
Oh gosh.
So nervous, so excited, so scared.
I've had butterflies all day.
Yeah. I don't even think we can check in yet.
Yes, yeah, so we should have been at the airport on the 18th at 11:30 p.m.
24 hours ago. We're in India.
Screamed soldier. At us.
Only one person in our hotel here by the park. Okay, this is enough. I've been up for 36 hours. You need to take me back to my hotel now. I don't have time for this shit.
Be sure to check the links in our descriptions for promos, discounts, packing, and more.
And of course, you can always visit our website for full itineraries, prices, and other resources.